Hi students, today's section is frequency response of RC network. Okay, this is the circuit diagram for RC circuit. We are using two components, that is one resistor and one capacitor. Okay, for input purpose we are giving function generator for giving sine wave signal. Already we have explained function generator and CRO last video. So what is the functionality of the function generator and CRO? Already we have discussed. So now we are using function generator for input purpose and CRO is output purpose here. Aim of this experiment is to test the functionality of the circuit for a sine wave input. Okay, here reactance of the capacitance is XC equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Impedance of the circuit is Z equal to under root R square plus XC square. Okay, from this you have to, by using potential divider method, you have to calculate V output. So output across capacitor you are taking here. So by using potential divider method, V out equal to total input V in into output across capacitor, so reactance of the capacitance by total impedance, that is R square plus XC square. From this equation you have to find out the cutoff frequency. So here this is the model graph of this frequency response of RC circuit. So in the X axis frequency and Y axis gain in dB. So gain equal to V output by V input. Okay, so V out equal to V output by V in is here XC by under root R square plus XC square. So this is gain. So gain in dB, how to calculate? Gain in dB equal to 20 log of V output by V in. So 20 log of gain. Okay, here this circuit is access low pass filter. Okay, R is connected here in series with capacitor. So it is low pass filter and output taken across capacitor. So it is act as low pass filter. So this is the graph of low pass filter. So we have to find out here cutoff frequency will be there here. Up to cutoff frequency, it allows only low frequencies. It allows only low signals up to cutoff frequencies and attenuates the high frequency signals. So allows only low frequency signals and attenuates the high frequency signals. So at cutoff frequency, what happened? At a cutoff frequency, here reactance of the capacitance equal to resistance value. At cutoff frequency F equal to FC, reactance of the capacitance is equal to resistance value. So what is the value of this at cutoff frequency? You will get minus 3 dB. How will it get here? So gain is V output by V in. So reactance of the capacitance is equal to resistance value. You have to substitute R equal to XC here. So you will get XC by under root R square equal to XC square plus XC square. So here R equal to XC at F equal to FC. At F equal to FC. So what happened here? XC by under root 2 XC square. Okay. X square and root will be cancelled and you will get here XC by under root 2 into XC. So here XC and XC cancel, you will get 1 by root 2. So gain will be 1 by root 2. At F equal to FC, you will get 1 by root 2 times of input voltage. So here V output by V in equal to 1 by root 2. So V out equal to what happened? 1 by root 2 times of V input. Okay, 1 by root 2 is 1.707 times of input voltage, where V out equal to 0.707 into V in. If it is in gain, 20 log of V 0.707, you will get minus 3 dB here. You have to draw a straight line here, and here at F equal to FC, you will get minus 3 dB in the graph. Okay, so first now you have to find out the cutoff frequency formula from this circuit. So what is happening here? Already we know the V output by V in equal to XC by under root R square plus XC square. So here to substitute XC value here. XC equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. So V output by V in equal to XC equal to, I am substituting 1 by 2 pi FC. 1 by 2 pi F into C divided by R square plus XC square. Okay. Sorry, XC square equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. You have to substitute here. Okay. 1 by 2 pi FC under root R square plus 1 by 2 pi F into C whole square. XC equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. So, V output by V in equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. You have to write down same. Here, 1 by 2 pi FC is LCM. So, 1 by 2 pi FC. So 2 pi fc whole square is LCM I am taking here. So what will happen? 2 pi f into rc square plus 1 square is 1. Okay, here again 1 by 2 pi fc divided by under root 2 pi f into rc square plus 1. So here square and root will be cancelled. You will get here 2 pi F into C. So this 2 pi FC and this 2 pi FC will be cancelled. So we will get 1 by under root 1 plus 2 pi F into RC. Okay, here V out equal to V output by V in equal to 1 by under root 1 plus 2 pi F into RC. Here I am assuming F 1 by 2 pi RC equal to FC. Okay. FC equal to 1 by 2 pi F into RC. From this equation, I am writing here FC equal to some constant value, that is cutoff frequency. FC equal to 2 pi 1 by 2 pi RC. So, what will happen in this equation? You have to write, substitute this value into this equation here. 1 by under root 1 plus F by FC. Here FC equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. 2 pi RC equal to what? 1 by FC. So I am writing here 2 pi RC equal to 1 by F into FC square. Already it is square will be there. So I am writing square here. This is also square here. Okay. So from this formula you have to, this is low, I told that this circuit is act as low pass filter. So at low frequencies what has happened and at high frequencies what happened, from this formula you can check it. F equal to 0, I am assuming here F at low frequencies means up to cutoff frequency, I am assuming that low frequency, that is I am assuming 0, ideal case is 0 frequency. At low frequency F equal to 0 means 0 by FC is 0, so 0 plus 1 is 1, so 1 by 1 is 1, so V output equal to V in. At V output equal to V in at F equal to 0. So what happened? If equal to 0 means here F equal to 0 means what happened here? 0 means it is open circuit. Reactance of the capacitance will be very high. At low frequencies, reactance of the capacitance will be very high. XC equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Reactance of the capacitance is FC equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Here, reactance of the capacitance and frequency will be inversely proportional. So, at F equal to 0, reactance of the capacitance will be very high. So, it is open circuit. If it is open circuit means at low frequencies, what happened? Whatever the input voltage will be there, that voltage will be acquired across output. So here also we have got from this one, F equal to 0 means 0, total voltage will be 0, 1 plus 0, 0, 1 by 1 is 1, so V output equal to V in. So V output equal to V in. So you get gain will be 20 log of V1, 20 log of 1 is 0 dB. So you will get approximately 0 dB up to cutoff frequency. Okay, after cutoff frequency what happened? If assuming high frequency is infinite, if assuming F equal to infinite means F equal to here infinite square is infinite plus 1 is infinite, so 1 by infinite is 0, so V output equal to 0. V output equal to 0 means at F equal to infinite, from the reactance of the capacitor will be 0 means capacitor will be short circuit. So here also you get at short circuit, what is the output voltage? You will get 0 voltage. From this from formula also you will get V output equal to 0 at high frequencies. Okay, so you need it. At low frequencies, output equal to V input. If we increase the frequencies, output voltage will be decreases, that is attenuated. Why? Because here reaching both the components in the circuit will be both are passive components. So passive components uses attenuate the input voltage. That's why the gain of the voltage, gain of this circuit will be, the gain of this circuit will be going to decreases and attenuated and goes to zero. If the component, any one of the component of the circuit will be active component, then the input voltage will be amplifying. So for example, if you are using transistor, op amps like that, then the output voltage will be amplified signal. So then gain will be very high. Here the gain will be less than or equal to unity. That's why you are getting here 0 dB. So gain of the unity gain is in dB will be 0 dB. Yes, 20 log of 1. So output by V input is 1. For low frequencies, V output by VNV is equal to 1 means, so 20 log of 1 is 0 dB. So you are hit 0 dB, and if you are increasing the frequencies, the because of the passive components, the output voltage will be reduces and attenuated and next goes to 0 here. At cutoff frequency, F equal to FC, reactance of the capacitance equal to resistance value. So at cutoff frequency, F equal to FC, reactance of the capacitance equal to resistance value. So at cutoff frequency, you will get 0.707 times of input voltage, V output equal to V out equal to V in into 0.707 times of input. Okay, then you will get minus 3 dB here. In gain in dB, you will get 20 log of V out by V in equal to minus 3 dB. That is, V out by V input is 0.707. So 20 log of 0.707 is minus 3 dB at FC at cutoff frequency. Okay. So now calculate the cutoff frequency. FC equal to 1 by 2 pi into RC. Already we have calculated here FC equal to 1 by 2 pi RC here. Okay. Cutoff frequency equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. From the circuit, we are used resistor value will be 1 kilo ohm resistor and capacitor is 0.1 microfarad. From this values, you have to calculate the cutoff frequency. FC equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. 2 into pi is value is 3.14 into R is 1 kilo ohm, kilo is 10 power 3 into 0.1 into microfarad is 10 power minus 6. So if you calculate it, you will get 1.592 kilohertz. FC cutoff frequency. At cutoff frequency, here in the graph, at F equal to FC 1.592 kilohertz, you will get 1.707 times of input voltage. Okay, you will get at cutoff frequency, output voltage will be 1.707 times of input voltage. It is getting or not? We will check it. Let's do the practical. Okay. Here, this is resistor, 1 kilo ohm resistor, and connected 1 kilo ohm resistor, and this is series in the capacitor, and this is the function generator. Positive is connected to the resistor terminal. Here, the positive is connected to the resistor terminal, and negative is connected to the capacitor second terminal. Okay, here output is across capacitor. So CRO positive is connected to the resistor and capacitor node, and negative is connected to the capacitor end. Okay, now start the function generator and CRO button. So tabular column will be this one. So frequency response of RC network, here serial number, frequency in hertz, V input in voltage, V output in voltage, gain equal to V output by V input, and gain in dB equal to 20 log of V output by V input. In this tabular column, you have to frequency, you have to the experiment is frequency response of RC network. So you have to increase the frequencies from 0 to high frequencies. So constant input voltage. Input voltage will be constant for all frequencies, and you have to observe on CRO what is the output voltage. Now keeping the constant input voltage, that is 2 volts, I am fixing 2 volts peak to peak voltage. Here I am fixing the input voltage, that is 2 volts peak to peak. So now I am connected function generator probe positive positive and negative negative. I am connecting one node here. Here connecting negative negative. Here positive positive. And you have to fixing that input voltage is 2 volts. So all of you know about CRO. So here 2 units will be there. 1, 2. 2 into volts per division is 1. So 2 into 1 is 2 volts. That is 2 volts peak to peak voltage is fixing. This voltage is connecting to the circuit. So positive is connected to the resistor terminal of this resistor terminal of the function under positive, and negative is both the negatives are connected to the capacitors in second end of this circuit, and CRO positive is connected to the resistor and capacitor node. Okay. Already I told that at FC equal to cutoff frequency, at F equal to FC, you will get 1.707 times of input voltage. So from these values, I got cutoff frequency equal to 1.592 kilohertz. So I am fixing the 1.592. Okay, 1.592 is 0.6. Here we are getting 1.4. Yes. Here one division, subdivisions will be 1.4. So input voltage is 2 volts. I am applying input voltage is 2 volts. So V out, I already told that at cutoff frequency, V output equal to 0.707 times of input voltage. Okay, V output equal to 0.707 times of input voltage. 0.707 times of input voltage. Input voltage is, I am keeping here 2 volts. Okay, so what will happen? 2 × 7 = 1.414. Here you will get V output equal to 1.414. Okay, and I am fixing the at cutoff frequency. FC equal to 1.592 is 1.6, approximately 1.6 kilohertz. Here output voltage will be 1.4. Is it exact or not? So I am getting here V output equal to 1.414. So from this table you have to write down like frequency increasing from 0 to high frequencies. At cutoff frequency you will get exact or not etiquette, and draw the graph between gain in dB into frequencies versus frequencies. So now I am keeping frequencies from 0 to frequencies. So already I told you that at low frequencies output equal to input voltage. Okay. So you have to keep it in XY mode, you will get exact value. Here 50 Hz. At 50 Hz you are getting 2 into 1 is 2 volts. So input voltage is already fixed to 2 volts, output voltage also you will get 2 volts. So gain in dB equal to V output by V input is 1. Okay. Next 100 Hz, one means 104 is approximately there. So 100 Hz output also, input is 2 volts, output is 2 volts. So gain will be 1. Next we have to 500 Hz. Increase the frequencies, vary. Five hundred Hz. You are getting input voltage is constant. 1.9 × 1, so 1.9 volts. Okay, at 1 kilohertz, I am getting 1.8 volts. 1 kilohertz frequency, input is 2 volts and output is 1.8 volts. Okay, now 2 kilohertz. Okay, already At cutoff frequency, I already told you, already discussed about one cutoff frequency 1.59 kHz. That is 1.6 kHz. So I am getting 1.4 here. At 1.59, so 1.59 kHz, 1.414 output voltage. Now next to be the 2 kHz. 2 kHz, input voltage is 2 volts and output is 1.4. Set it exact value. So it is less than 1.4 and 1.35. So I am writing here 1.38. Okay. Next to 2.5 kHz. If I am increasing the frequencies, so output voltage will be attenuated and reduces the values. Why? Because reactance of the capacitance. So 2.5 kHz, input voltage 2 volts, 1.2 volts, output voltage is 1.2 volts. Next to 3 kHz, so 3 kHz, at 3 kHz, so output voltage will be 1, so 3 kHz, input voltage is 2 volts constant, output voltage is 1 volt. Next to 3.5 kHz, so I am getting here 0.9, 3.5 kHz, 0.9 volts, so 4 kHz, 0.8, 4 kHz frequency, input voltage is 2 volts, output voltage is 0.8 volts. 5 kHz, next we go to the 5 kHz. 5 kHz frequency, I am getting 0.7. 5 kHz frequency, input voltage is 2 volts, output voltage is 0.7 volts. Next, go to this 7 kHz, increasing frequency same here. 7 kHz, I am getting here 0.5. 7 kHz, 2 volts input, 0.5. And 6, it will be in between 0.4 and 0.6. 0.5 volts. Next to 9 kHz or 10 kHz. Next go to 10 kHz. Increase frequencies. Next to 10 kHz. At 10 kHz, output voltage will be 0.4. 0.4. 10 kHz, input voltage is 2 volts, 0.4 volts output. Next to go to the 12 kHz or 15 kHz. At 15 kHz, so 0.3. So output voltage is at 15 kHz, input voltage is 2 volts, output voltage is 0.3 volts. Next to go to the 20 kHz. 20 kHz, output voltage is 0.2 volts. 20 kHz, input of 3 volts, output voltage is 0.2 volts. Next to go to the 30 kHz. 30 kHz, increase the intensity value, you will get exact values. So in between 0 and 0.2. So I am getting, I am assuming 0.1 volts at 30 kHz. Next to go to 50 kHz. kilohertz, 50 kilohertz at frequency voltage will be less than 0.1. So you can write that 0.05 volts. Okay, at 50 kilohertz, 2 volts input. Now go to the very high frequencies, 100 kilohertz or 200 kilohertz, it is going to 0. At 200 kilohertz, our input voltage is 2 volts and output is dotted, that is approximately 0. Okay, line will be 0. So, if we increase in the frequencies here from 50 hertz to 0 to 200 kilohertz, output voltage will be attenuated and 2 volts to it is going to 0. And if we keep in the input voltage is constant, that is 2 volts. After measuring the all the values for of V output for input constant for increase the frequencies, I have calculated the gain. So V output by V input, V output by V input for all the values and gain in dB, 20 log of V output by V input. So the values will be like that. So at low frequencies it is 0 dB, after that it will decreases and goes to minus negative. From this value I have drawn the graph. Here in the x axis I am taking the frequency and y axis gain in dB. Okay, in the here in the x axis you have to take it, values are here 1 2 3 4 5 like that, at 9 1 again 1 2 3 4 5 like. So you have to take it here, first I am taking 100 hertz, next this is 2 3 4 5 600 700 to 1 kilohertz. After that 1 kilohertz, 2 kilohertz, 3 kilohertz, 4 kilohertz, 5 kilohertz, like that 10 kilohertz. You have to next to 10 to 100 kilohertz, 100 to 1000 k, 1000 k means 1 megahertz. So it is multiply with 10 times. Okay, 100 into 10, 1 kilohertz, 1 kilohertz into 10, 10 kilohertz, 10 kilohertz into 10, 100 kilohertz, 100 kilohertz into 10, 1 megahertz. And in the y axis I have taken gain in dB. So we have 0 dB, next to minimum value is minus 32 and negative values. So I have taken here each unit equal to 5 dB, okay, 5 dB, 10 dB, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and it may higher 0 dB here. From this table I have drawn these values at 150 hertz. So 50 hertz means here 100 hertz will be there. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. At 50, I got 0 dB. And 100 hertz also, you got 0 dB. Okay, 100 hertz, you got 0 dB. Next to 500 hertz. At 500 hertz, I am getting minus 0.44. So 500 means this is 100, this is 200, 300, 400, 500. 500, here 500. So each the subdivision equal to 1 dB, minus 1 dB. So it will be in between. Minus 1 and 0 dB, so minus 0.44 here. Next at 1 kilohertz, at 1 kilohertz, so this is 100 hertz means it is 1 kilohertz. At 1 kilohertz I got minus 0.9, near to 1, minus 1 dB here. Okay, at cutoff frequency, at cutoff frequency, what is the cutoff frequency for our circuit? 1.59 kilohertz here, 1.59 kilohertz, this is 1 kilohertz, this is 2 kilohertz, so each subdivision equal to, this is 1 kilohertz, 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, 1.5, 1.59, approximately 1.6, at 1.6, you got 1.59 kilohertz, here you got minus 3.011, so minus 3 dB, at cutoff frequency you got minus 3 dB, okay. Next, you have to take it same values and draw the graph, so it will find all the ways and you have to draw a graph to the points like that. So you will get graph like low pass filter it is. F equal to FC, gain will be minus 3 dB. This circuit cutoff frequency equal to FC equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. Okay. For this circuit, cutoff frequency equal to 1.59 kilohertz. I got it. Okay. So you have to do for different cutoff frequencies. For different cutoff frequencies, you have to select different resistance and capacitor. So if you change the resistance and capacitor, your cutoff frequency will be changes for this circuit. You have to do for different cutoff frequency values.